Hi, I'm Stefan Algatz, Senior Climate Advisor here at the World Bank Group. Today, I want to show you what needs to happen to global greenhouse gas emissions to achieve different outcomes in terms of climate change. And this is really important to understand the sense of urgency in the discussions taking place in Glasgow. We're going to break down this analysis by country income groups so that we can understand how decarbonization needs to happen across the globe. And of course, it will be a very different story in a country like Norway or a country like Malawi. Okay, now let's take a look at current trends. This figure shows the emission of greenhouse gases up to 2018. And you see the constant increase over time. Now we can extrapolate those emissions in a business as usual. And of course, future emissions depend on many factors: demographic trends, economic growth, what people consume, and how we produce our food, goods, and services. Technologies also matter, of course, and progress in green technologies like solar power play a key role. But in spite of all of those changes, emissions have been growing. And if we ignore the few years around the COVID-19 crisis, we see that this trend would be expected to continue without climate policies. Projections suggest a more than 50% increase in total emissions through 2060 in the absence of action. This would lead to 4 degrees of warming, with, of course, catastrophic consequences to lives, livelihoods, and ecosystems. Now, we can break down those emissions by income group. And the red area on top are emissions from low-income countries. The yellow show the lower middle-income countries. Blue is for upper middle-income countries. And the green space here is for high-income countries. As you can see, low-income countries are always responsible for a very small proportion of global emissions, even though they are the countries suffering the most from climate change. Now we can look at the objectives of the Paris Agreement. How much do we need to change those emissions to limit warming to 2 degrees? Look at the drop that we need to see in emissions starting in the next few years. This drop would have to start immediately, and emissions would have to go towards zero very quickly. If we want something safer and target the 1.5-degree target, then this is how emissions would have to change: a much sharper drop and much more ambition in our policies. Now, we can see that all countries in all income groups have a role to play if we want to reduce emissions to achieve the 1.5 or the 2-degree target. If we show a scenario in which high-income countries and upper-middle-income countries are doing what is needed to achieve the 1.5 target in terms of temperature, but if lower-middle-income countries and low-income countries cannot do the same because they don't have the resources to do that, what you see here is that we will fail to reduce emissions enough to limit the temperature increase to 2 degrees. And by 2060, low and middle income countries would be responsible for most of the global emissions. This really shows that even though efforts need to start with the largest emitters and high income countries, we also have to make sure poorer countries can get on board and act and get on track toward net zero emissions. Thank you for watching, and do look out for the other data presentations in this special series.